Charles, what brings you here?
Luxosaurus has been accepted as a new species.
Charles, you were too kind. Thank you.
What do you have there?
Elasmosaurus.
Here. Thank you.
So what's up with you?
Not much. You know that Elasmosaurus said is supposed to be on the other side. See the...
No, it's not.
Yeah, the headphones are... They're not proportionate to that.
Wow, I'm impressed. Your pride is bigger than your stature.
What'd you say to me, Eddie? You got something to say?
Charles, I was only teasing. You don't have to take every bit of banter to heart.
You're one to talk. Remember when we were in Germany and we met Darwin? You wanted his head on a plate.
First of all, Darwin needs to stay in his own lane. He doesn't know dick about paleontology. Second, it's not my fault people can't handle a little bit of criticism.
If it weren't for Darwin, we would be out of a job. We wouldn't have sufficient cause to go after these bones.
Just go to your office, Charles. I don't want to hear it. Oh, and leave the water.
We found a collection of body fossils up in the northwest. With this find, the expedition could be worthwhile.
Good man.
Give me all the good stuff. Give him the extras.
What the hell was that? Were you bribing him? This is supposed to be a 50-50 arrangement.
You're imagining things, Cope. I was just congratulating the boy.
Cope? Well, that's a new low, Marsh. Listen, if I hear any more of your corruptions out here, else I'll just let that college of yours know. Maybe I'll write them a little letter. Let them know how Othnell Charles Marsh can somehow get results so quickly out here, Dick.
Professor Cope, sir, where are you going?
He spends his time admonishing me. All the while, he's harassing our workers.
Who are you talking about? Professor Marsh?
Exactly. We need to find a way to prove that his lies are just that, lies.
Well, I think you should know Professor Marsh can outfund you now. He's working for the USGS.
What? That's the one thing we had on him. Okay. What do we have at the Montana site that can help us?
We have a mine, but...
It's perfect. Make sure that we own it.
Sure thing, we'll get on that.
Good morning, Professor Cope.
Yes, how may I help you?
I'm gonna need to see proof of ownership for your entire collection, sir.
Under whose authority, may I ask?
Well, the United States Geological Survey.
God damn it. Professor Marsh is after my collection now. I'll have you know, sir, that I used my wealth to collect these fossils. And I have proof. Also, a document that your superiors might be interested in. And this journal is a record of all of Othnell Charles Marsh's misdeeds, corruptions, and outright felonies. I'll submit this journal as proof of my ownership of these fossils, but also as proof of Professor Marsh's crimes. I'll make copies and submit the originals to you straight away. Good day, sir.
How do you want?
Well, I see your venom hasn't lost its potency. You're still the same sharp, pitchfork that you always were.
Get to the point, Cope.
I'm here to offer a truce.
A truce you have nothing to bargain with.
As a matter of fact, I do. Contained in this journal are testimonies from all your workers, from your foreman, even that precious dig boy that you love so much. Oh, also those ruffians. You know, the ones that you sent to harass my workers? Well, their testimonies are contained right in here. Look, I'll level with you, Marsh. I'm tapped out. I'm completely broke. But if I publish this journal, oh, you'll be worse off than I am. Well, here, I'll tell you what. I'm gonna go ahead and stop publishing all my criticisms of your digs. You know, all the mistakes that you make in digging for fossils. If you stop trying to steal my collection.
Go to hell, Cope. You think you can blackmail me? Your reputation will be worse than mine. I did bribe my way up there. I did. But did I ever think to blow up any fossils? How many did you blow up? 50? 60? You're a disgrace to paleontology, you half-wit.
We'll see how half-wit we both are. Doesn't it hurt when you try to think with that dick brain of yours?
Go to hell, you pompous swine!